Hey guys, welcome back. This is Rahul. So in this video we will talk about the folder structure of Cypress and what are the files involved and their purpose. So this is the first folder, Cypress. It contains four subfolders and we are missing two folders here, that is screenshot and video folders. Okay, so the first folder is fixtures folder. So you can say this is a folder which will contain all the test data. The test data can be in the form of a JSON file or a CSV file or a text file. So Cypress recommends to store all the static test data inside this fixture folder. Then we have the integration folder. This is one of the most important folder. It will contain all the test cases. So these are the examples test cases which are provided by the Cypress team. You can look into these test cases to understand how it is working, but we will talk about writing test cases in detail. And then we have this plugin folder. This contains one index.js file which is used to load plugins. You can write code to load plugins before the execution or after the execution. And this is a support folder. Basically this will contain all the code which is reusable, and you can create some custom commands as well. In this commands.js file you can create your own commands. This is the syntax and we will talk about it in detail. And you can keep as many files as you want, but the custom commands will be here only in this commands.js file. Otherwise you can create as many files as you want. All the files needs to be JavaScript file only. And this is the node modules folder. Node module folder, when we install Cypress we type the first command, that is npm init, and this file was created. The package.json file was created. And then we gave all the required information, like the default information which we gave. And after that we installed Cypress, and when we installed Cypress this node module folder was created. So it will contain all the information of dependencies. All the dependencies are downloaded in this folder. If you download any other package from npm website, then those dependencies would be inside this node module folder. Okay, so this is your cypress.json file. It is used to override the default configuration. Like Cypress has some default configurations, let me show you. npx cypress open. So I'm opening the Cypress runner, and there we can see the default configuration for each file, for everything, like the default timeout or the package names. So this is the default configuration. Like we can say fixtures folder, this is the fixtures folder by default. You can change it, you can rename it. Okay, you can delete the fixtures folder and create your own folder and place it, change the folder path. Then this screenshot folder, then the timeout setting, default timeout is 4000 milliseconds, that is 4 seconds. So you can overwrite this command in this cypress.json file. You can change it as per your need. This is the package.json file. This is the first file. And whatever dependencies we have will be mentioned here. And there can be multiple dependencies. This is the latest version of Cypress. And this is package lock.json. So Cypress depends on some dependencies. Cypress in turn depends on some dependencies. Those dependencies are mentioned here. We don't need to change anything in this file. We will never change anything in this file. We can change something in this dependencies file, but we will never touch this file, because it is indirectly calling all the dependencies which Cypress needs or any other module which we are using. So that's it guys. We will run our first test case in the next video. थैंक यू।